Hello everyone, in this session I will discuss the marking pattern of IRMS and I will especially focus on the commerce optional, right? So there are two stages, prelims and mains, right? And in the prelims there are two papers, general studies and CSAT. General studies has 200 marks and out of these 200 marks the cutoff will be calculated based upon the merit, right? So normally if we see the civil service examination, the cutoff has been somewhere between 95 to 100 marks in previous 3-4 years, right? So in 2023 or 24 or some later, the cutoff should be near about civil services only. In fact, in 2024 or later, the cutoff is supposed to be increased. It might increase because there will be certain people who will be exclusively preparing for IRMS. So those people will focus on prelims more and they will increase the cutoff, right? So this is a competition based cutoff, and based upon this cutoff only, the students are selected, right? Then second is CSAT, Civil Services Aptitude Test. In this test, again, it has 200 marks questions, right? And this is based upon the qualifying criteria, right? So here you need to score 1/3 marks. Like out of 200 marks, you need to score 66.67 marks, right? So only that much marks you have to require. Otherwise, you know, no cutoff based criteria. It is a qualifying paper, right? So primarily in the prelims, general studies is the main paper. For cutoff, general studies has to be focused more, right? Now coming to the mains. In the mains, there are two category of paper. Category one is commerce optional. Category two is the qualifying paper. Qualifying paper or the language paper, right? So in the commerce optional, again, there are two papers, paper one and paper two. In the paper one, there are 250 marks. In paper two, there are 250 marks, right? And total 500 marks. The cutoff of mains is based upon the commerce option only. So if you see the civil service examination, the past record, the marks in the commerce optional have been between 250 to 300, right? So in the IRMS, these marks are supposed to be increased. What is the reason? The reason is very simple, because in the civil service IAS exam, students are focusing more upon IAS, GS papers, 5 papers are GS. And here they will be preparing exclusively for the commerce, right? So here, out of 500, you should target minimum 300. And this cutoff might go to up to 350 also. It can even go more, not a surprise, right? Then in the qualifying paper, the name of the paper is qualifying paper. That means you have to score certain minimum marks, which is 25% marks. You have to score only 25% marks and you get to qualify this paper. The marks of this paper will not be counted for merit cutoff, right? These are only qualifying nature. There are two papers. One is the English language and second is the Indian language. So each paper 300 marks and you need to score 75 marks in each paper, right? So this is the marking pattern. The third stage is the interview. In the interview, out of 100 marks, you will get the marks, right? And the final selection will be based upon the marks you get in the commerce optional, that is here 500 marks, and the marks that you get in the interview, the combination of two, so totaling of commerce optional marks and the interview marks, based upon that the final cutoff will be counted, and the top 30 students in 2023 and later, as per the vacancy, the selection will be done, right? Those 30 people will again be categorized into unreserved, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, OBC, and physically handicapped, and this economically backward classes, right? So there will be reservation based separate cutoff for each paper. There will be the reservation based separate allocation of seats, right? So that will be there. I am making more videos on many important aspects. So subscribe to the YouTube channel and join our Telegram channel. The link has been shared on the description. And also, this is a playlist of the IRMS. Please watch all the videos and you will get a lot of useful information. All the best. God bless you.